हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ सुषमा सी, आई एम वर्किंग एज अ गेस्ट लेक्चरर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, एडीबी फर्स्ट ग्रेड कॉलेज, हरपनहल्ली। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन अवर लास्ट वीडियो वी आर डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मोनो हाइब्रिड क्रॉस एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट डाई हाइब्रिड क्रॉस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर गोइंग टू नो अबाउट डाई हाइब्रिड क्रॉस इन डिटेल, let us know what is dihybrid cross. When a cross is made between two genetically different plants which differ in two pair of contrasting characters is called dihybrid cross. As we saw in monohybrid cross, in that case the two organisms or the two plants which are involved in monohybrid cross are having all the similar characters excepting one character. One character must be different in case of monohybrid cross. In the same way, two characters are differ in case of dihybrid cross. That means the parents which are involved in dihybrid cross must have all the similar characters excepting two characters. Such cross is called as dihybrid cross. The resultant of this cross is called dihybrid. For this cross, Mendel selected two pea plants which are differ in two characters. One is form of seed and the second one is color of the seed. The two parents which are going to be involved in dihybrid cross are having the character like one plant is going to carry a seed or going to produce a seed of round form with yellow color, and another parent is going to give the seed wrinkled form with green color. Such plants are taken for crossing by Mendel. Let us know what are the results got by Mendel. Parents round yellow seeded plant is going to be crossed with wrinkled green seeded plant. This is the phenotype, whereas the genotype is capital R capital R capital Y for round yellow, small r small r small y for wrinkled green. According to Mendel, we know that each trait of an organism is controlled or determined by a pair of factors or genes are called alleles. So here the round character in a pea plant is going to be controlled by a pair of factors, those are called alleles. So round is going to be influenced by two factors, one is capital R and another one is capital R. In the same way in case of yellow, capital Y. In the same way in case of wrinkled green, small r for wrinkled seed, small y for green colored seed. These two plants are having only one possible type of gametes. The gamete which is going to be coming from round yellow plant is going to give a gamete carrying capital R capital Y because it is homozygous in condition. In the same way, the homozygous conditioned wrinkled green will also going to give gametes which are carrying small r small y genes. When both are involved in fertilization, the F1 hybrid will going to form. The F1 hybrid is going to carrying all the factors of both the parents, capital R capital Y, small r small y, but the F1 hybrid will going to give the type of seed is round formed seed with yellow color. This indicates round yellow colored seed is dominant over wrinkled green. Or round is dominant over wrinkled, yellow is dominant over green. Mendel continued his experiment to observe the results of F2 generation by allowing the F1 generation for self-fertilization. The F1 hybrids have possibilities of gametes as one is having capital R capital Y, the second one is capital R small y, third one is small r capital Y, and the fourth one is small r small y. These are the possible types of gametes in both type of parents. For each gamete, there are four types of possibilities. This gamete may going to fuse with these four types. This may going to fuse with these four types. This may going to be fused with these four types. Again, the same way, the fourth one is having all the four chances of fusion with these four gametes. So let us know what are the results got by the Mendel in F2 generation by having the Punnett's square. F1 hybrid is heterozygote yellow round in nature. As I already told that each one gamete is having all the four possibilities. So Mendel tested all the four possible characters so that in F2 generation the 16 plants are possible. The 16 plants with a different genotypes are going to be possible. If capital Y capital R is going to be fuses with the ovum carrying capital Y capital R, then it is resulted in yellow round, that too homozygous yellow homozygous round. In the same way, if capital Y capital R will going to be fuses with the egg carrying capital Y small r, then also the seed is going to show the character as yellow round with the genotype homozygous yellow heterozygous round. So there are 16 types of different genotype plants are going to be formed. Let us know how many differentiates are going to be coming from each plant. So this is the chart showing the genotypes of all the 16 plants, the phenotypes of all the 16 plants, and the ratios. In case of monohybrid cross, Mendel get the result 3:1 as a phenotype and 1:2:1 for genotype. In this, Mendel expected the same result for F2 generation in case of dihybrid cross, but here the result is different from monohybrid cross. Here he got about 16 plants with different types of genotypic characters. Some are similar in nature. He got a phenotypic ratio as 9:3:3:1. Among these 9 plants, the 9 are yellow round, 3 are yellow wrinkled, 3 are green round, and 1 is green wrinkled character plant. In these, this is the phenotypic ratio. The genotypic ratio for this plant, for the dihybrid cross, is among 9 yellow rounded plants, 1 is homozygous yellow round, 2 are homozygous yellow heterozygous round, 2 are heterozygous yellow homozygous round, 4 are heterozygous yellow, heterozygous round. So in yellow round, among 9 yellow round, these 4 types of genotypic plants are going to be resulted. In the second case, that is in the 3 yellow wrinkled, one is homozygous yellow, homozygous wrinkled, and in 2, sorry, among 3, one is homozygous yellow, homozygous wrinkled, 2 are heterozygous yellow and homozygous wrinkled. And among green round, one is homozygous green, homozygous round. 2 are homozygous wrinkled, homozygous green, heterozygous round. And the last one plant is green wrinkled, that is both are recessive character, so carrying homozygous green with homozygous wrinkled genes. So the phenotypic ratio for dihybrid cross is 9:3:3:1, whereas the genotypic ratio for the dihybrid cross is 1:2, 2:2, 4:1, 1:2, 1:2, 1:1. Totally 16 plants. Among these, remember, among these 16 plants, 9 are yellow round, 3 are yellow wrinkled, 3 are green round, and 1 is green wrinkled. On observing these peculiar result, Mendel stated the following statement, that is, when factors for two or more pairs of contrasting characters are brought together in F1 hybrid, they get separate independently from each other at the time of gamete formation. This law is called law of independent assortment. The meaning of the statement is, the parents which are involved in dihybrid cross is having the character as round yellow and wrinkled green. These are the original parents. Round yellow plant is going to be crossed with the wrinkled green plant. There are two characters. One is form of the seed and another one is color of the seed. When these two characters are contracted or merged in F1 hybrids by crossing those two plants, all the characters are going to be present, all the factors are going to be present in F1 hybrid. Like this is round yellow F1 hybrid. It is having all the 4 factors. Round yellow from round yellow parent, wrinkled green factors from wrinkled green plants. Due to the dominance of round yellow, the round yellow character is going to be visible in case of F1 hybrid. When this undergoes selfing or allowed to selfing, 4 gametes are going to be formed. Four possible gametes are there. Law of independent assortment is, here the characters are going to be mixed each other. The parent, original parent, is having yellow, round yellow character. In the results, we are going to get round green, wrinkled yellow, it is not a rule that round factor is always going to be with the yellow factor. That's why we are going to get peculiar types of results like round green and wrinkled yellow type of characters are going to be visible in case of or resulted in case of F2 generation in case of dihybrid cross. All the factors are not going to be dependent on any other factor. Single factor is not going to be dependent on any other factor. For example, round factor is not going to be dependent on yellow factor. Green factor is not going to be dependent on yellow factor. They will going to be get separated during the gametes formation. This is the actual meaning of law of independent assortment given by the Mendel by observing the results of dihybrid cross. Remember, the phenotypic ratio of dihybrid cross is 9:3:3:1, whereas the genotypic ratio of dihybrid cross is 1:2, 2:2, 2:4, 1:2, 1:2, 2:1, total 16 plants. Thank you.